Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how I do the acoustic guitar recording of an Awash track that we're doing, together with our singer and acoustic guitar player Geert, and I will show you the preparations, which gear I'm using for recording and how it is set up. I will show you the actual recording and I will show you the end result. So let's go! So welcome back to the new song production series, which is a series of videos in which I detail all the steps that I go through in this home studio to produce a new track for my band Awash. I've already done videos about how I start a project, how I add the initial drum track, bass track, piano track. I've also already added the electric guitar parts. So if you like these kind of videos and want to see what happened before this acoustic guitar recording, please check out the series. I will link the playlist at the end of this video. But now, as to acoustic guitar recording, what it all starts with is preparation. Let's have a look. Yeah, in preparation I've already set up the microphone in my little vocal booth. It's a Neumann KM84, which is really a classic microphone for recording acoustic guitar. Sounds very nice. Set up with a little reflection filter, so that I don't record too much of the vocal booth room sound, which is obviously not a very nice sounding room. I'd rather add ambience in the mix. Then it's going to the Heritage Audio preamp, which is a Neve 1073 clone. Gain is set at around 60 dB. A slight boost on the highs, slight boost on the mid highs, 3.2K. The lows are off and I have a low cut filter at 80 Hz. From there it's going to an 1176 clone with pretty fast attack and almost set at the fastest release. Compression ratio is 4:1 and I usually get around 5 dB of gain reduction when I'm recording this. And from there I was going into Cubase, 10.5 Pro at this time, and I already have a track set up for recording the acoustic guitar. Yes, he's very much on time for a musician. Going into the studio and unpacking his stuff. A little joke about where his whiskey bottle is.
Waar is de fles?
En of course tuning the guitar before recording.
Nou erin te knallen. En dan te kijken dat je niet helemaal naar beneden zakt.
Ja.
Warming up in the vocal booth. The microphone is around 20 centimeters from the guitar. It's pointed at the joint of the body and the neck, which I find gives the best sounds usually. And I'm just recording this with one mic.
Okay, let me interrupt here for a second, because in that clip that I just showed you with Geert warming up and showing the mic positions, the guitar kind of sounded out of tune again, at least a bit wonky. So the cause of that was this little thing, a capo. Because as you just saw before, he tuned his guitar like this, without a capo. And then to play the song, it's in F minor, he put on a capo on the first fret, and it basically caused the tuning to go off again, which is not uncommon. So a few tips when recording an acoustic guitar with a capo: just tune up like without a capo first. It's pretty much in tune. Then put on the capo. It should be on there without too much extra tension on the strings. Of course, it presses the strings down, but it shouldn't put tension on the strings in either that way or that way. Now, if I now play the F minor chord, it's okay, but it's a bit wonky. And I'll bet you if I would check the tuning on my tuner now, some strings will be off. So always check your tuning after putting on the capo. And what can you do then to correct it? Well, first of all, you can try to correct it without turning the tuning pegs at all. If the strings are sharp, which is usually the case if you put on a capo, then you may be able to tune them down again by just pulling on the strings a little bit. If they are sharp, which is not often the case, then you can push on this side of the string to try to get them in tune again. And if they're really off and it doesn't work, obviously you have to turn the tuning pegs and stretch them a little bit to make sure that the string tension gets distributed evenly on both sides of the capo. And that can be a bit hard depending on how tight the capo clamps onto your neck. In any case, before recording, check the tuning after putting on the capo. And now back to recording. Okay, so let's have a look at what we recorded. Over here you can see the Cubase project that I have been using so far to record this song. Starting with the reference track that we recorded during rehearsal. A little scratch vocal that I'm not going to go into. The acoustic guitar that we recorded. More on that later. Dark green is the electric guitar that I recorded before. Purple is the piano, the bass guitar, and a stereo mix of the drums. So if we now zoom into the acoustic guitar recording, which is this part with all its takes on different lanes in Cubase. First thing I want to mention is that in the notepad of this track, I've basically made some recording notes of how I recorded this part, so that in case we ever need to redo something, or even in case we record the next song, that I can get back to how I recorded this part if I really like it. And I can say actually the recording notes of this song came from the previous song that we recorded, so that I know which mic to use, how to set the preamp and equalizer, how to set the compressor, which I know sounded good on the last track, so it's probably a good start for this track as well. Now I've already edited this part and I've used track versions to sort of keep the history of the editing. So this is basically the first recordings that we started with. Let me show you a bit what the basic recording was. Yeah, so a very natural sound from this KM84 mic that you really can shape into anything during mix time. Now what we already did during the recording session together with Geert is that we already cut up the various parts to select the ones we like. Yeah, so over here you can see that we've basically selected parts of the 6th and 7th take and we added an 8th and 9th take for the ending. So what I also do during this stage when I'm making the initial comp with the artist is that I put on a bit of a comfort compressor just to give the sound a little bit of extra, in this case from the UAD. And I also put on a little comfort reverb just to make it already sound a little bit better. Typically some processing that I would also do during mix time. Now after he had left, what I did, I made a fully comped version. So I threw out all the parts that I didn't need. And I made sure that, let me zoom in here. Over here you can see some rakes that he did in the beginning. Sounds like this. Now because there are some silences in between and this part of the song is really still quiet, I edited out the in-between silences because there's also always a bit of extraneous noise and I don't want to have that in my recording. Other things that I did is where we comped things together, I made a little crossfade, as you see. So there's quite a lot of time that goes into this whole process, and if you want to see how I did that, I will link a video up here in which I show you how I do this for an electrical guitar part. I will show you how I use track versions to keep track of the history of the edit, and also how to use group editing to edit actually multiple tracks at the same time they belong together. Check it out, it's interesting. So finally let me show you how it sounds combined with the other tracks. Thank you.
Okay, and in the more heavy part, starting from the bridge. Okay, so much for the acoustic guitar. Thanks again for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and ring the little bell icon so you know when I post another video. And if you have any more detailed questions about what I've done in this production, please post them as a comment and I'll try to respond. The playlist on my left here and on your right is actually the other videos that I made in this new song production series. So maybe something to check out next. See you soon.